Watch this scene very carefully.
Bison bought this land for the amber deposits back in the 90s, but we've managed to turn it into a safe haven for about 20 displaced species. The first generation came from Sorna. Most of the Nubar dinosaurs are here too.
Hello, what's up, everybody? And today, I'm combining multiple theories of how Camp Cretaceous could possibly connect to Jurassic World Dominion. And it has to do with Isla Sorna. More specifically, the dinosaurs on it. So, as we know in Camp Cretaceous Season 4, the first time Isla Sorna gets mentioned is by Mae Turner, where she specifically says the T-Rexes are from Sorna. Here we get another reference to Isla Sorna in, I believe, Episode 8, where we see the Spinosaurus that's way similar to the one on Isla Sorna. I don't think it's mentioned in the series that this is the one from Isla Sorna, but this is probably the same one. The last Easter egg of Isasaur and Camp Cretaceous is when we get confirmation that the Brachiosaurus, I think his name is like Rebel or something in the show. Or actually, I kind of forgot. I haven't watched the show in so long. But anyway, where he explains it's like 2 months old and the DNA was extracted from Isasorna. So anyway, also we can confirm from a Dino Tracker website that Isasorna dinosaurs have been living in the Dominion era. This is including the JP3 Velociraptor, Jurassic Park The Lost World Tiger Strike Raptors, and also the Buck and Doe Tyrannosaur from The Lost World are also living in the Jurassic era. Now you may be thinking, how are they living in Jurassic World Dominion? Like, how are they still alive? Like, how, I mean, you may be thinking that Ramsey Cole actually said in a scene in Dominion, which you saw at the beginning of the video, that the first generation came from Isla Sorna. However, what if I were to tell you, and just to be clear, I'm missing multiple theories to try to connect Camp Cretaceous to Dominion here. That they're taking more dinosaurs off of Sorna in Camp Cretaceous Season 5. Because as we know from the Season 5 trailer, or at least a teaser, I'm not sure if that's a real trailer. Like, I actually gotta make a speculation video when we can expect the trailer for it. Unless this is an official trailer or something. But anyway, as we can tell, they're taking dinosaurs off of Nubar. But what if I told you they're also taking dinosaurs off of Sorna? And this also kind of connects with Biosyn, that maybe Biosyn's showing up in Camp Cretaceous Season 5. Because as we know, we can see a person with a watch holding the Barbasol can, who's most likely gonna be a animated version of Lewis Dotson. Which is really exciting for any Jurassic fan. So this means, like, honestly, maybe Biosyn goes to Nubar at some point. This could possibly lead in a story where Lewis Dotson actually convinces Brandon Bowen possibly to join him and work for him. And this would mean that's right, Brandon Bowman is actually Ramsey Cole, because that was a theory for a while, and I'm basically bringing that theory back, that just maybe he goes, because as we know from the trailer, you can clearly see, you think is there's his brother, jump off a boat and land on Isla Nublar, as you can tell, because you can see the mountains in the background. So maybe, just maybe, Darius' brother, Brandon Bowman, is Ramsey Cole. And this would actually explain his redemption arc in Dominion and why he was a good guy the whole time or something. Because he was Darius' brother the whole time. Or something. So anyway, now another theory I had that could also connect to this. The theory that, how Camp Cretaceous connects to Dominion is Kayla Watts the daughter of Mae Turner from Camp Cretaceous? Because as we know in Camp Cretaceous, there's actually been a theory that Kayla Watts is actually flying that plane in Camp Cretaceous, which would make a lot of sense. In fact, this plane could even be for Biosyn, the one we see in Dominion, possibly. I'm just throwing that out there. But this would mean that Kayla Watts is the daughter of May Turner, which, like, I think it would be cool if this did happen, because that would mean, like, I don't know, her redemption arc would make sense in Dominion and why she wanted do help Claire and Owen and all of them. That would kind of make sense. Because of, like, what happened between Camp Cretaceous and Dominion. So, anyway, what if I also were to tell you that, remember that article a few months ago that basically, I forgot who wrote it, but they're basically an article about Camp Cretaceous and how they wanted the ending to be, like, seeing the dinosaurs in the real world. Well, what if I were to tell you that that's exactly the end of Camp Cretaceous? They are bringing the Sworn of Dinosaurs, or, no, actually, I got a better idea. Biosyn buys Mandacorp, takes over the company, and then they transport the Sworn of Dinosaurs to the mainland. And that's why we see the Buck and Doe's Tyrannosaur in Jurassic World Dominion, because they're transported there from Sorna by Biosyn. And this could even be during the events of Camp Cretaceous Season 4, just in pure speculation. So basically, this would mean that, so this would also be why we don't see Spinosaurus in Jurassic World Dominion. And now I think about, I'm combining a lot of theories here. Like, this is my biggest video, although it's not going to be the longest, it's just going to be my biggest theorized video. Or, like, my biggest theories. But, like, the Spinosaurus is basically transported somewhere else or something, maybe. I don't know, maybe it dies or something. Just saying, because its Spinosaurus is in Jurassic World Dominion. And you know, Biggie and Little Edie aren't in Dominion either. Which means maybe they're transported somewhere else by Biosyn or something, possibly. Also, you may be thinking, how is the Barbasol can alive? And answer that question. Because it was destroyed in the Jurassic Park game. The answer is, Rusty probably stepped, not exactly on the Barbasol can, or something. But anyway, this has been my most insane theory yet. And by the way, sorry I haven't posted my Jurassic World Dominion review yet. I've been waiting to do that till I see the movie twice, which I haven't seen it twice yet, so. Plus, I'm waiting to review every film, too. Once it releases on Blu-ray, I'm probably going to review every Jurassic Park film, like, for real. This time. And, like, compare it. And, like, compare the connection to Camp Cretaceous Season 5 when it releases. And hopefully we'll get a trailer soon. And maybe, also, maybe they may bring Toro to the mainland. So, this theory suggests that maybe they bring them somewhere else. Like, maybe they are in the Biosyn Sanctuary, but you can't see them in Dominion or something. Plus, like, I mean, either Toro dies or Toro is transported to mainland or something, because we don't see Toro in Dominion. We've only seen that demon Carnotaurus, which it confirmed not be Toro now, even though I literally took a picture, the one from Vulcan. I literally saw the scar on it. I don't even know how it's possible. Also, possibly Bumpy is in Dominion, which also would connect Camp Cretaceous to it. But I think my fear is more likely that Dominion connects because of Isla Sorna. And possibly we could even see, like, a flashback with Charlotte Lockwood in season in season 5 of Camp Cretaceous. I'm just running out there. We could see like Charlotte Lockwood. I think that would be cool if we saw a flashback of her late living on Isa Sorna. And then we actually get the embryo crate in Camp Cretaceous. And that kind of connect my theory before season 4 came out of is that crate in Camp Cretaceous. Maybe a Macy Lockwood, maybe the Indoraptor could show up. I don't know. There's a lot of things that could really connect Camp Cretaceous to Dominion. However, I think Isa Sorna's the most likely reason for now that they're gonna transport these dinosaurs from Sorna to the mainland. Is as we know from the article, they actually said they want people seeing dinosaurs in the real world. And as we know from the Dino Tracker website, that the Velociraptors and Sorna live in the Dominion era between FGC and Athena and Dominion. Tiger Strike Raptors are alive. The Buck and Doe, also in Dominion, are alive, which they're actually in the movie. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed my theory on how Camp Cretaceous connects to Dominion. Or possibly, how it possibly connects. This has actually been my biggest video yet. This is actually the first time I'm using iMovie to do my video so I can edit the whole thing together, which is the same process I'll be using when I review every Jurassic Park movie and probably every video going forward. So anyway, I hope you all enjoyed my Camp Cretaceous Season 5 theory video. And honestly, I just hope we get a trailer soon. Like, I'm sure it's not gonna spoil much, if anything, but like, we should expect the trailer in like at least a few days' times or something. So anyway, hope you all enjoyed and have a fantastic rest of your day. And peace out from the Jurassic Channel. Bye.